Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Journey to Wisdom and Wealth. My name is Tara. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Thanks so much for joining me. You know, you're the part of the what? Grateful gang, gang, gang. Grateful gang, 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 gang. Grateful gang, gang, gang. Grateful gang, 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 gang. And if you're not a part of Grateful Gang, we'd love to have you. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button, okay? It is free 99. It costs you nothing. So let me give you a minute. That wasn't a minute. That was a few seconds, but you get it. Are you subscribed? Are you subscribed? Okay, thank you in advance. I'm going to pretend I know you subscribed. If you like the video, just give it a thumbs up. I really do appreciate that. Today's video, we're going to be going over week 3 of our 12-week year. This week was not the best. It threw me off because I had a guest, and I'm tired of saying that because that really, it cannot continue to be my excuse. Like, I really just need to be able to roll with the punches, but that's who I'm becoming, not who I am, but I will be. I am becoming. So let me just tell you what it's about. I'm gonna show you the screen in a moment. Things I've learned, let me just show you with that, is that I still don't have enough discipline to have snacks in my house. I bought a whole bunch of snacks to accommodate a guest that was staying for a couple days in my home. And on top of them eating them, I was eating them. No control. And I also realized that I don't get as good of a workout in at home as I think I would as an outside setting. So what I might start doing is going ahead and like paying the $7 to do a Zumba class here or there just to get some real life out in the world, be motivated by other people in a class experience. And it's down the street. I've been there. I do like it. I should have thought about that when I was doing my budget. I could have put some extra money towards that, but that's okay. I might just take my allowance money and do that this week because the class is like $7 per class or whatever. Other things I've learned, I can't think of right now. Oh, to really think about what I'm doing, because I'll say that I think I should lose weight this week because I was doing decent or the same, but I wasn't. So let's really look at the real picture. So let's get into week 3. Let me set you up so you can see the screen and we'll talk about what happened. Okay, welcome to week 3. Week 3 was January 23rd to January 29th. As far as Read, Pray, Live It. So Monday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, every day except for, every day except for Thursday was the only day I didn't get to read my devotional, but I caught up on Friday. On that has become more of a routine for me, which I really enjoy. Meditate and pray. Don't get out of here. Meditate 2 to 3 times a week. I did meditate actually 2 times. I could have swore I meditated at least 3 times this week, but it says I only meditated twice this week, and that was toward the end of the week. I don't believe that. I think I did at least 3, but 2 is what is required, so that's fine. Sermon 5 days a week. Sermon 5 days a week. I did 4 days. So I didn't get 4, but I do think I'm going to listen to one after I get off. So I'm going to get 5 for Sunday because Sunday is normally my sermon listening day. So we're going to say that we hit that goal. Drink 84 ounces of water. I'm not even adding this to next week's goals because I didn't hit it but one day this week, and it's very annoying. It's very annoying to even look at. One day, it was Thursday that I hit that goal. Smoothies, I did 4 days out of the week. I'm supposed to do 5, but I only made it 4. That's okay. Workout is 3 to 4 times a week. I only worked out 2 times this week. I was supposed to work out today, but after getting off the scale, I got annoyed. And then a 16-8 fast. I did the 16-8 fast every single day except for Tuesday. Tuesday, I was hungry. I think I explained this to you. Is that the same Tuesday? That's not true. I think I had my 16-8 fast every day this week. Sometimes these little things are not clicky-clacketing right. They, like, come off, and that's annoying. But I'm going to put a picture in the dailies or right here so y'all could see that I actually did that. Meal prep, I did that Saturday and Sunday of this week. You know me? Saturday and Sunday. And then weigh-in was today, Sunday. Unfortunately, weigh-in, you see Sunday? No, weigh-in was Sunday. I'm up 2.2 pounds, which is quite discouraging. But now looking back at the tracker, I didn't work out all 3 days. And I sure ate a lot of snacks. And I definitely didn't hit my water intake. So is it wrong? Probably not. Pay money to the credit card. I actually scheduled a couple payments this week, but not to the Discover, but definitely to the Capital One. Now that we're using Capital One and Discover, I just scheduled a payment there. 3 to 5 no spends. I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 no spends. I almost didn't grin Tuesday, but then it said the eye doctor doesn't count, and it absolutely doesn't. If I have to pay a copay for something, I don't count that as no, I count that as a no spend day because that's not money I wanted to spend. Decluttering, I only decluttered 2 times this week, which was Tuesday and Wednesday, which is not great because that's one of my main goals. And decluttering was supposed to happen 3 to 4 times a week. It was a weird week, y'all. That is the breakdown of my week that just passed. It is what it is. I'm not gonna give up. I will say though, with the weight thing, it's annoying me because I'm very heavy, so I really shouldn't be going up and down so much. But I do believe that what it is probably the need to start counting calories. As much as I don't want to count calories, it's like the bane of my existence. I think it is something I'm gonna have to do in order to see results. And at this point, I'm just tired of being heavy. Like, I wanna wear cute dresses. I wanna dance and whine and do you can see my whole waistline, dust off my waistline, dust off my hips. You know what I'm saying? But in my house, in the privacy of my house. But still, like, yeah. I'm just tired of being this weight. It's uncomfortable. I can't tie my shoes. It takes so much breath just to walk to the parking lot and work. Like, yeah, I need to do it. As much as I don't want to, I'll probably be downloading MyFitnessPal. However, I'm sure I'm going to mention this in the video that I'll be doing a liquid fast with one of my friends who brought this up. This was not my idea, y'all. But I'm supposed to be doing a liquid fast starting February 1st, I think for 10 days. So I'm not counting calories then. You know, I'll start counting calories again when we're back on a regular schedule, probably in week 5 or 6 of the 12-week year. So we're halfway there and then we'll switch it up. But until then, I'll just try and do my best. Yeah. That is how this week went. I hope you are doing well with your goals. Expect there to be ups, expect there to be downs. Just a learning experience, y'all. If as long as you're doing something, you're not failing, right? Keep trying, you're not failing, you'll get it. And that's the way I'm just gonna keep telling myself. I'm not getting it right. I gained weight this week, but at least I'm doing something. You know what I'm saying? I'm not just sitting on my butt and saying whatever, and I'm not giving up. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Enjoy. If you wanna see how the week actually went in person, keep on watching. If not, you can end here, but don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you want to subscribe. And if you like the breakdown and me tracking every week, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button as well. One last question before I let you go and watch the video. What are your thoughts on me creating a separate lifestyle home channel with this kind of content and not adding it to the budgeting channel that I started? Let me know down in the comments. I asked it a couple times, I think, in my video, so just let me know. Thank you. Hey everybody. It's Monday and Tuesday in a nutshell. Can't really see you right now because my eyes have been dilated, so let's hope it's all good. On Monday, I got up. I worked from home because I was taking a half a day at work. I did not get my workout in. I did do my prayer and devotional. That is becoming a routine I really love, and it's become quite easy for me to do. Starting to feel like my day is not complete unless I do it. So I definitely did that. I went to work. I straightened up a little bit because I have a house guest coming. I had a house guest coming last night. And my first house guest, you guys. And then I had that follow-up. So that's why I'm here. I had the follow-up doctor appointment for the mammogram. They did take some pictures again, and then I also did an ultrasound on them again. And good news, there were two little things. I'm gonna put a picture of it here in case you really want to see. But there were two little things there. They actually look like a little peanut or whatever. And they were, the doctor says, either a complicated cyst or a fibroadenoma benign tumor. And so everything is good, no cancer in sight. However, I do have to go back in 6 months because they want to make sure it's still the same size, nothing crazy is going on in there with it. As well, they say it could be actually hormonal, so it might be gone the next time they look. So that is what is going on with that, and that's pretty much took most of my day yesterday. And then like I said, I was preparing for company, so came home, did the rest of that, and they came really late. And it's my cousin and her baby and her baby, so that was fine. Came late, got home, went, got them settled in. She was super happy. She's like, "Oh my God, it's so nice." And then because I set up the room and everything. There might be a video coming about what I did for my first guest, so that's why I'm not going into super detail. And that was Monday. And so then Tuesday, we're here. Hi, today is Tuesday. I went to work today. I left around 2 because I had an eye doctor appointment. I can't see. Everything is super bright and my eyes are dilated. I can't see anything up super close, really good. I had to drive home, which was scary. And they forgot to give me those really dark glasses, so I had to find some sunglasses because everything was like super overexposed. My uncle came and got them for the day. And so I'll let them know in a few that I'm home if they want to come back or they're hanging out with other family. Whatever, whatever on that front. As far as today, it's supposed to be a decluttering day, but because I spent my weekend trying to get myself together for this guest, I did prep some pasta, but I have another pesto pasta that I want to make. So I've got the water boiling, ready for that. And I made the chicken last night so that I could just make like a chicken, grilled chicken pesto pasta situation. What else? I think that's it, y'all. So as far as decluttering, I think what I'm gonna do is since we're going around the room, there is that box right there, the Amazon box, because I can't really see. I don't want to try and do too much, so I'm going to get the Amazon box, and I'm because that technically is the next thing around the room, because those are all like my sorting bins. I'm going to see what's in there and see if I can empty it out or put it somewhere that it needs to go. And then the rest of those are like pillows and stuff. So I'm not really sure what's gonna happen with the pillows and all that right now. I really wish there was like a closet down here. I might end up bringing all the extra pillows upstairs into the storage room just to get them out of the space for now. Or putting one on the back of that office chair. And then maybe I'll even, I don't know, because I can't see the instructions. I was gonna say maybe I'll put together the sound system for the TV. But right now, it's just clearing that Amazon box because over there, the only other things are waters. And I'm not really sure where the water is going to go until we get to the pantry. And then once the pantry's cleaned out, hopefully the waters can go at the bottom of the pantry. Okay, we're talking a lot. But you guys, everything in this box that I'm supposed to be decluttering is like all brand new stuff from Amazon. So I have another box over there that has Amazon stuff. I might just put them all in the same place until we get to the putting things where they belong phase. That they have turned from their wicked ways. Sorry guys for the bad lighting, but these are all the boxes that were inside this box that are empty. I'm about to break them down and put them in the garbage. And then what I did was transfer what was in there to in here, and I still have room. So eventually we're gonna get to like using all this stuff. Actually, we're gonna keep it in this box, I think. And then when we're done, like the massive declutter, then we will take these out and put them in their prospective rooms for like organizational purposes. So, yeah, that's what I'm doing with that right now. And that is out of that corner. I'll be putting that back in that corner. I might even look into those cameras tonight. I don't know what I'm gonna do with all these pillows. I might actually, like I said, bring them. Might bring them to the upstairs and put them in the storage room for now, but except for one that I'll leave on the chair. But yeah, that's it, guys. Have a good night. Good morning, everyone. What happens to my eyeliner? It's fine. It's too early. It's like 11 o'clock in the morning. How is it gone? How? Anyway, it is Wednesday. Happy hump day. Happy midweek day. And I am working from home today because I told y'all I had a house guest and I thought they were going to be here all day, but they're actually gone now. So, but I'm like, it was not a nice day outside. It's actually very gloomy and it was raining earlier. So, I'm actually glad I got to work from home today. I am all set up. They're working, and I've just made my breakfast a sourdough bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich, and my smoothie, y'all know, spinach and all the fruit. I was so thrown off today. I didn't even get to do my devotional yet, but I bought it down here so that when I take a break, I can do that. I'm in a weird way, just want to like take a walk today instead of doing like full workout. But outside doesn't look so great. So maybe when I get off, if it's not raining, I might take that walk because today is a workout day. And that's pretty much how I'm doing today, y'all. The only reason I actually made myself breakfast as my 16-hour fast, it's actually, I think I'm 30 minutes past, is because, I had company and I didn't want to send them off without anything in their tummy. All right, guys, I'll talk to y'all later. Hey, beautiful people. I figured I would just take a walk today. I'm out here and I already don't feel like it. But y'all see those clouds? It goes from sunny to looking like it's about to pour on my head. But let's see how much I can do. All right, guys, I'm back inside. I took a 30-minute walk. And thank you, Crystal. And I'm telling you, I feel like I was sleepwalking. I felt like I was sleepwalking. I'm so tired because I was up with my guests until like 1 a.m. And I'm working, but I'm tired. I'm glad I took the walk because I knew I needed to do it and I knew my body was not going to be ready for no strenuous exercise later. So I'm glad that I did it. But I just wanted to report back. Walk is done. And I'm actually doing laundry, like the sheets and stuff that was on my guest bed now, since I can work and the machine's doing all the work anyway. That was my check-in for today. I actually feel like since I did my walk midday, I might find something to declutter. And I'm thinking I'm gonna go. Oh, I'm gonna put this together and hook it up to the TV. I'm gonna move these items, I think, the water and the pots. These are the pots my sister got me for Christmas. I think I'm gonna move those to the dining room because this will eventually go into the pantry, but that's not done yet. We're on our way over there though. And the pots will go in the kitchen, and dining room, kitchen are kinda in the same vicinity. So there's that. Someone's at my door. Okay, guys, so the subwoofer and the sound bar is there for now. I think I liked the simplicity when that wasn't there, so I'm thinking I'm going to mount the sound bar probably under the TV and maybe I'll put the subwoofer down the bottom. That's what I'm thinking, but at least it's out of the box, excuse me, and I can get rid of that box and I'll keep all the mounting stuff. I think this goes into the back of the TV, but I think I'm gonna have to mount it on the wall before this is gonna reach. So there's that. All right, I'll talk later. That is the end of Wednesday. I'm so tired. I think I'm going to bed early today. Hello, beautiful people. It is Thursday, Friday Eve. Happy Thursday. So it's now 6:16, and I'm gonna pay a few bills, and then I'm gonna make myself, I think, a sandwich, like a grilled cheese sandwich. It is a decluttering day, but instead I came home and I recorded my video for my paycheck that just hit today, as well as closing out the last paycheck. I have a video on my phone with last week's check-in for the 12-week year that I'm almost done, so I can upload that, like done editing, so I can upload that. I'm going to see if there's anything small I can still declutter, because technically it's a decluttering day. But honestly, I'm not feeling it. Look how red my eyes are, y'all. I'm tired. And oh, I should put some drops in it when I'm done. Y'all, so I'm now reading this bill I'm about to pay for my electric. So it's $139.64. And look at this. It says 99, your bill would be $99.24 for the next month if you enroll in flat bill. So no matter, you have a fixed amount for 12 months, regardless of your usage. No rising bill during the summer months. No settlement fee at the end of your 12-month contract. So I can enroll. What I'm gonna do probably is look at. I just put drops in my eye. That's why it looks like this. What I'm probably gonna do is look at my previous bills and see what they are, because if they're all within that under the $99 or average out to about $99 range, I might sign up for this flat bill, because it doesn't matter how much I run my AC or how much I run my heat for the next 12 months, it'll always be $99.24. That might actually be a win. However, when I was doing it regularly, I felt like I had some $50 months, some $80 months, things like that. So is this a win or not? So I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna just pay my bill right now, but I'm gonna go back and look at all my bills for electric for the last year and see what they average out to. I'm gonna let y'all know. Hello, beautiful people. It is Friday, end of the week, and a good day. So work went well. It's neither a declutter or workout day. Although I think I might declutter some in this corner, maybe the papers that are on top, and see what's over there, just because I didn't really declutter yesterday. I was gonna work out, but I don't know, something about Friday is never feeling like a workout day for me. So I'll probably work out Saturday and Sunday morning. I prefer to work out in the morning. Oh, this clock's 5. Look at that. Mostly just random triple numbers often. I do. Or double numbers. I forgot I had that chicken in the cell, I think. All right. So let me show y'all what I bought at the food store, because I'm not eating, trying not to eat out too much or really at all. But it's $20.32. I spent $20.32. I'm so mad I accidentally put it on my Discover when I meant to put it on my Capital One. I bought 5 items, y'all. 5 items. And it cost me $20.32. Here are the items. Popcorn, 240. Oh, too close. 246. Land O'Lakes butter, 206. Corned beef is what really brought us over. Each one of these was $5.40. And the eggs were $2.46. Nope, $2.44. I only get the little half a dozen because it's just me. But I have some bananas in that bag over there that I'm gonna make some banana bread, and I needed eggs because I only have one egg left. Really, $21 on 5 items. But this is kind of like meat, because I already had white rice in the fridge cooked. I figured I wanted to do something quick and easy for Friday, and corned beef is quick and easy. It's a little salty, but quick and easy. So I'm just gonna stir that up with some onions and peppers that I already have cut up, and some garlic. And that's a wrap. That's a wrap, y'all. Hey, y'all. So I'm actually still in the kitchen, but I made a banana chocolate bread. I don't know if I told y'all, but I made that. And I'm actually prepping my pot to make my corned beef, and my rice is already made, so I'm just gonna heat up some rice. I didn't end up doing any, what's the thing called? Any decluttering or anything like that, because I've actually been in the kitchen the whole time. And when I've been waiting for the bread to make, I've been kind of watching y'all videos. Y'all might see that I commented on some people's stuff. However, because I can't use the burner and the oven at the same time, I had to wait for the bread to be done before I could make my dinner. And it's literally almost 8 o'clock. Actually, it's yeah, 7:57, like the planes. Yeah. Now that the bread is done, I'm making my food so I can finally sit down and eat. So I'm probably not gonna do anything. I was supposed to meal plan today, but baby, I have no idea. I have no idea. We don't have much in. Like, I've been really using what I have. Not even really on the door either. But I did take down some, and the fridge is kind of empty. But I did take down some chicken and had that defrosted today during the day. I'm gonna season that bag next to it was onions that I chopped up. So I'll probably season that up tomorrow. So we'll have definitely chicken. But I'll figure it all out later. I'll talk to y'all later. I'm tired. Good morning, beautiful people. Happy Saturday. It's Saturday and I am still a tiny bit tired. I went to bed around 11 and then woke up at like 4 a.m. Mascara all up in my eye. Anyway, so today I've done my prayer, my devotional, read Psalms 3, I think it was, where David is surrounded by all his foes on every side, and he has the heart of faith where he knows that God is bigger than all of these things, right? So we just have to remember that if things aren't going our way, or we're fearful, or we feel like all our enemies and all the bad things have come up against us in life, remember that the Lord is bigger than them all. And if you cry out to him, he will help you fight your battles. Then I spread my bed and I am about to work out. So I put on some workout clothes. You guys, I'm so agitated, which I knew I shouldn't have done it. I did a 5-minute morning meditation as well, but I'm not really agitated. I'm just like kind of disappointed. So I got on the scale on Thursday because I felt like it. And I think I was up like 1 pound, and I wasn't really stressed about it because I was like, I had been having a lot of pasta and stuff because I didn't have money to go out to buy food, so I was eating what was in my house, and I was having a lot of snacks because the guest was here. However, I thought I did pretty well the next couple days, decent, and when I got on the scale today, which is Saturday, so from Thursday, Friday, just Thursday and Friday, now it's Saturday morning on the scale, and the scale says that I gained like 4 pounds. How is that even possible? How do you gain 4 pounds in 2 days? I don't think that's possible, but I don't know. Maybe I had something that I did have corned beef yesterday, and that's kind of salty. So maybe my body's just retaining water from the corned beef. We'll see tomorrow, original vegan. This is why I hate weighing in for scale stuff. It just becomes kind of, I don't hate it, but it's very discouraging sometimes. And I think this is one of the reasons why I end up quitting my weight loss journey, because I feel like I'll lose some weight and then it's like it just come right back, even if I continue to kind of do the same things. Anyway, I'm just not going to discourage. I'm about to do a workout. I'm about to do this one. It says dumbbell shred with Grow with Joe, and it looks like two other people. 30-minute intense burn. I do have some pound weights here in my room, so I will do that and hope for the best. I haven't done like a dumbbell workout yet, so I'm just always worried that, okay, adding the weights is gonna add muscle, which then is gonna make more on the scale. But at this point, it is whatever. I think I'm doing better than I was doing last year, and that's what I'm gonna keep saying. I can't do anything about what the scale was. Although, to be fair, I will also say that I didn't have the best week. I didn't eat any out food, like fast food restaurants or anything like that, except my boss bought us scones, but I didn't go crazy on those either. Yeah, and I've just been having my smoothie and my lunches and sandwiches and pasta, but it is what it is. I'm gonna keep going for this 12-week year and see where we end up at. And then for the next 12-week year, I'm going to add in something that I hate to do, but it might be the missing key that I need to do. All right, y'all, let me do this workout. Thank you.
Okay, y'all, see me? There's barely any sweat on my forehead. Those girls were sweating like they were in a sauna. I don't understand. I'm gonna go into that video and see if they, because I only have 5 pound weights, and maybe they had 10 or 8. So I'm going to look and see how much weight they had and see if I can replicate that, because I was like, what am I doing wrong? And I'm saying this from a point of a person who's always sweating. Like, I'm always sweating. Always. So, yeah, that was weird. That's why I don't mind the discipline of doing the home workouts, but sometimes, I don't know, it's something about a gym or a studio that really like gets me going. So, I do think for February, I might have to make that plunge and go ahead and sign up for the gym or something. That's just me thinking right now. However, it's now shower time. I did my workout. I do feel a little sweat in my back, but I mean, they were sweating, y'all. Okay, bye.
Hey, it's me again. So I've had my shower. I've straightened up my bedroom. I did one load is in the washer, sorted another one and one on the floor. Those are all clean from the other day. And I'm actually checking out my girl, Tasha. She's on her second channel, Tasha Loves Life. And she's doing her first plan with me for February. I'll make sure to link it down below so you guys can check it out. Go ahead and support her other channel. She has a budgeting channel as well, which I've talked about on here before. But definitely go ahead and support her other personal lifestyle kind of channel. And love the nails, girl, as well as loving the color scheme you're going with. I just sat down in my desk area, which I actually need to pack this desk up to return and get a proper one. That's why the box is still here. But I'm gonna work on my meal plan right now. So I'm gonna get on my Google Sheets, work on creating a February calendar. She inspired me, girl. You inspired me to work on my February calendar. Because only January is there, and January is pretty much at the end now. So I'm gonna work on my February calendar as well as work on my meal prep. Also, you guys, I'm gonna do probably a poll on my community tab, but I want to know if you guys want me to do a separate channel for like home and 12-week year stuff, and then separate that from my budgeting channel. Let me know if that would be easier or if that would be better. I know they say when you have a YouTube channel, you should niche down, and I'm wondering if that's what's stopping me from getting to my 1,000. But let me know your thoughts. I'm gonna get this computer started. One load of clothes is out, so I'm about to switch those to the dryer and put in another load. I love when I can do two things at one time. One that I don't have to think about because really I'm not a multitasker. Okay, guys, so I'm done my calendars. That's January, February, and then March and April are at the bottom there. Quarterlies, I've added my weigh-in days. This has an extra like day down the bottom. I've added in my paydays. And then I think I'm going to go and look for something on Google that shows me all the holidays. Probably more of what I'm used to. So, like, pull it up so y'all can actually see. So now on this one, it actually does have Valentine's Day, which is the 14th. And then I believe my cousin's birthday, now it's really close, is on the 13th. So, Valentine's Day. And I'm gonna probably try to add a few little stickers like hearts. I just copy and paste things to make my own stickers. And then, Quiz B-Day. Yeah. Do a link. I think I could just copy a link to this page here. And then if I want to go here, I think just be able to double click there. Good. And then check in the month. That might be the best thing to do. So my second load just came out, or my first load just finished. So I'm going to go ahead and put in my second load of clothes. And after the second load of clothes, I'm done with the calendars for now. I'm about to start a new sheet. Looking around the camera. Start a new sheet for meal plan. Because I want to have a meal plan in my 2023 budget set up. I'll talk to y'all later. So it looks like this laptop has a focus feature where it sets a 30-minute timer for you. So that you can stay focused for 30 minutes. I guess it doesn't let any updates or anything come while you're doing it. And it's like called a focus session. I don't know if y'all can see that. But let me stop talking because I'm supposed to be focusing. Working on the meal planner now. So I went with more of just a basic scheme to kind of go along with the calendar scheme because everything is kind of like this green and peachy color, which I'm kind of vibing with. So breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks, notes, and groceries, which are kind of like the same thing. And then Monday through Sunday, and then I'd put each what I'm eating here. I left these little blanks here because I'm thinking that I can put in like recipes if I wanted to do it. So I'm not really a breakfast person, so most of these will be NA. Do a salmon salad. Probably if I have enough salmon, probably that those 3 days. But I wanna see if this will also work. Let's close that out. Let's go to, can y'all see? Let me zoom y'all a little bit. Let's go to Skinny Taste. Y'all know about Skinny Taste? I have one of their cookbooks and I like their website because a lot of their recipes are free. I'm trying to let me make sure y'all can see. And I'm gonna search salmon salad. Okay. Salmon Caesar salad. So this is kind of like how I like it, but I'll just get the Caesar dressing and the Caesar whatever, and then maybe she makes her salmon a specific way, so I'll use that recipe. So what I think I can do is just, since I'm on this recipe, I can just copy it and then just put it, and that's why I left this section right here, is I'm gonna paste the link to that there. Maybe I need to make it a little bit bigger. Okay, that's better. Okay, so that's our salmon salad recipe. I'm gonna close this page and see if it'll bring us to it. If we just click on it, boom, we'll be able to get there and we'll just be able to reference our recipe. I only have 4 minutes left on my focus timer, which means that I have been focused for 26 minutes. So I'm going to keep looking at some recipes in case I want to find some that I can do with my chicken. This 5-spice roast chicken leg look good, honey. But I'm going to look at those, link them in, and see what I would need to buy on my grocery list. And if it brings me out of budget, we'll just throw them chicken legs in the air fryer, see. But I hope you enjoyed watching me kind of maneuver my little meal plan situation. I like this. Again, let me know if you would rather me do these kind of videos on my budget. I feel like meal plan is kind of budget related, but like the other stuff that pertains to home, let me know. And if you feel like the meal plan is not budget related, let me know that as well, if I should like create a My Humble Home channel. All right, I'll talk to you guys later. Now I am pulling a Candace and I've got my site up. I've got my Kroger website up. I got my Walmart website up because I was looking for 5-spice, but this is ridiculous. These on the Walmart website, like all over the place. And I was thinking about making this 5-spice chicken. I've lost it. It's on a previous page. But I did find Candace where they have, this is all the BOGO deals and the weekly ads and the digital coupons. Like you can check off what you want. So I'm just going down and see if there's anything like I can use on my chicken or something that I want to use for this week or buy because it's on BOGO. Ooh, that Dole fruit might not be a bad idea. But yeah, because fruit is always kind of good. All right, I was just sharing with y'all my process and where I'm at my meal prep. Also, I forgot that I told my friend that I was going to do a liquid diet with them for like 7 or 10 freaking days, right? And so that starts February 1st, and February 1st is Wednesday. Could y'all believe it? February 1st is Wednesday. So that makes my meal prep a little easier, I guess. Don't make my life easier, but that means I'm only gonna do the chicken, like no sandwich. I won't have to buy any sandwich stuff. I'm just gonna do the smoothies and the chicken, rice, and vegetables for Monday and Tuesday, and then salmon salad for Monday and Tuesday's dinner, which means I only need to buy one salad and one smaller piece of salmon. And I already have the chicken, the rice, and I just need to I'm sure I have frozen broccoli in my fridge that I can just make. So I could know I'm not even spending any money on this dinner, really, unless I choose to do one of these recipes over here and buy like a few other ingredients. Which I only thing I saw that I kind of really wanted to try was that 5-spice chicken right there, but I'd have to buy 5-spice. But I'm gonna keep looking at my ads as Candace would tell me to do and see if any, oh, look at that. I don't like the stems though. But there's some broccoli that would have worked for veggies, but I think I have broccoli already. But okay, I just hit you guys on where I was, and my plan is already 1:35. After this next block of 25 minutes of focus is done, then I'm done. All right guys, so I am finished with my meal prep situation. I'm about to make a little small list on my phone. It shouldn't be too much. I'm gonna go hang out with my sister when I'm done here. And the laundry is on its last drying load. Everything has been washed and hung, so we're drying now. I have my chicken for tomorrow, so I'm gonna cover that up in the fridge. That is done. One thing I didn't do that I really kind of wanted to do today was the invoices. But I think I told my sister I was gonna come by her. So I'm gonna go by her, obviously. I'll probably have to just get up early and do the invoices tomorrow, which is fine. And I'm bringing my sister and her husband a piece of the chocolate banana bread I made yesterday. And then I cut a few slices for grandma to try as well. Tomorrow, I feel pretty good about where I'm at, because I'm probably just gonna throw the rice in the rice cooker tomorrow, make some white rice, make like a stew chicken. And I'm gonna go to Publix and pick up the buy one get one broccoli, because it has like broccoli and cheese green giant, I think. Hopefully that's still there. And then I told my sister I was gonna stop by Publix before I got to her, and then she asked me to buy this pizza, I forgot the name already, but it's supposed to be pepperoni. I think I know what it looks like, because they're on buy one, get one as well. And then I'll go hang out with her probably for the rest of the evening. I'll see if I remember to get any. I know my niece went to sleep, so if she's up and about, I might get some footage of baby girl, Ray Ray. Yeah, that's it, y'all. Just wanted to check in, let you guys know where I'm at with my process for the day. I feel pretty good. Like, I like my days like this where I can kind of go at my own speed and pace, but I still feel like I'm getting things done. All right, I hope you had a great Saturday.
Are you on the painting? You break dancing?
It's dark over there. Are you coming back? And the running, 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 and the smile. That's a little close to the thing.
It's too away from the
She pushed it right back. Until you go smack dab into the wall, will you understand why your mother moved it? She's probably like, I pushed it against the wall, so when I slide, it's already against the wall. Now she's gonna keep doing that. She's eating the fake pickle. Eat the real food and stop the fake food.
It's just the imagination for me, dog. Are you?
Yes. I always forget to film her.
Oh, you gonna throw backwards?
Yep. Whichever direction the wind blows.
Don't throw it at me now. Okay.
Oh, okay. Where'd it go? Cucumber. Where'd it go?
Can you say
it? It looks like a jalapeno.
Sure, I ain't got no stem.
It looked like it, though.
It got a little.
I can't see that far. They gave me fake trials.
It's a kuma.
Okay,
can you cucumber. Say cucumber?
Can you cucumber. Say green? Small words, mommy. Small words. Look at this energy. Like, babe. Why? Don't slide on the... On she's on. I'm tired just watching you.
Hey, y'all. It's like 8:20. I need to text my sister that I made it. 8:20. Just got home from my sister's house. And I had went grocery shopping at Publix, really nothing too big. I spent like 50 something dollars, but 10 of it was $10 some change. I actually bought two pizzas. It was a buy one, get one for my sister. So actually I spent 40 something dollars, but I spent 50 something dollars because I didn't ask her for the money back or anything. So let me show y'all what I bought. I got this woman's multivitamin. Because I needed some gummies. I love gummies. Is it gummies? Yes. Vitafusion Women's Multivitamin. And that was a coupon for that. That's why I picked it up. Then these were buy two, get one free. I've never had these. And they're called Probiotic Kombucha. Tastes great with less sugar. It's 35 calories in one thing. And only 8 grams of sugar and no added sugar. So I got the strawberry lemonade because most of those were gone. So I'm assuming that it was delicious. So I got two of those. And then the one that I got for free also was another one that was gone, which was a flavor I really love. There's a texture to this bottle and I really like it. It's called Mango Passion Fruit. Sounds amazing. There's some light. That would be great. Okay. And... Candy, shout out to you. I was all up in that BOGO section. This is some Bragg's Organic Apple Cider Vinegar Probiotic Shot. This is ginger turmeric. This looks to be something new that they have. Never tried it, so I figured since I was doing, this is what it looks like. We know that Bragg's is a really good brand, so there's 4 in here. Why does this feel like it was leaking or something? But... these were, I think, 11 something, but they were $3 off. So I figured I'd give them a shot since I'm supposed to be doing this whole liquid thing. Let's get some good stuff in there. I ran out of salt. I haven't bought salt in a while. I ran out of salt, so I bought myself some kosher salt. One bag down. And then they had these buy one, get one free. So I bought a broccoli and cheese sauce. One which I think I'm gonna have with my chicken and rice tomorrow. And then I also bought a Green Giant Simply Steam with Mrs. Dash salt-free seasoning, garlic and herb vegetable medley with broccoli, cauliflower, roasted potatoes, and carrots. And I believe this is a part of the buy one get one free tip. So then also buy one get one free was this chicken. So I think this is the Publix brand. They're like organic brand, Greenwise. So this is all natural drumsticks. So I got some drumsticks for $5.86. That was a higher price one. So I got the chicken thighs for free because they were $4.99. The same Greenwise all natural chicken thighs. Bone in. You had to get the bone in one to get it, but that's okay. I like chicken thighs. So that is what I purchased. And that is all I got. Doesn't look like much, honestly. And then the two pizzas, but I don't have them with me. Yep. Just wanted to let y'all know what I got. Later. Good morning, everyone. Happy Sunday. I got up. I didn't even bother working out, y'all, because I was a little annoyed. I got on the scale. It was better than it was Saturday morning, but it still was a gain of weight. I am going to try not to get annoyed, but I was like, you know what? Just reevaluate what you're doing. This is week 3. I'm going to finish out week 4 because it does have the liquid diet in it that I'm doing with my friend. So I don't want to start what I'm thinking week 4 into 5. So once I have a good stopping point, I'm going to add something in that I think is what I'm missing
and why I'm not seeing the results I want to see. I do completely believe in giving yourself time to adjust to all the things. It's the beginning of the year, and I'm so grateful for this 12-week year plan because it's really helping me stay on top of my stuff. And I'm so grateful for you all for helping me stay on top of my stuff, because if I didn't have to be accountable to you or myself, I probably wouldn't be doing this. Like, I'd probably just be like, whatever. I'm just being honest. So I'm glad, and thank you, Dee, Budgeting Dee. She's been working with me behind the scenes, and me and her kind of communicate to try and help each other with that as well. Anyway, so I got up, did my devotional. I had my shower. Now I'm down. Oh, I've edited a video. The ending part of this video I edited, like, Monday through Saturday. Then I'm going to add Sunday on, and I'm going to upload it. Y'all are probably going to see it like right behind the one you saw for last week, because I was behind on last week. So I just don't want to get completely behind. I want this one to come out in a timely manner as well. So my plan right now is I'm about to go to Sam's Club. And after I finish Sam's Club, I'll go to my parents' house and do the invoice and then come back and cook. I wanted to wash my hair, then I remembered that I don't have any hair stuff anymore. I finished it all last time I washed my hair. I'm just like, this is not good. I just need to have somebody else do my hair. At this point, I'm tired. But we're going to try to remain positive on this journey and realize that it's always not going to go as I wanted to go. And I did sit down after talking about how I felt about the gain in weight from yesterday, like in the 2-day span. I did sit down and really think about it, and I had to be like, Tara, were you really good? Like, so honestly, I think that I did good as far as not eating out. Like, I wasn't eating out. I didn't eat out last week at all. But the fact that I had the guest, I did buy a lot of snacks for them. And then when they were gone, I kind of like ate all the snacks. And I know myself, I don't have the discipline to have these things in my home. This is why I don't usually buy them for myself. But because they were in the house, because I had the guests, I bought them. And then I felt like throughout this last week where I had the gain, I ate a lot of junk food. Although I wasn't eating out, I was eating a lot of junk. We get to Sam's Club. I'm not buying too much there. I calculated, I think, spending about $30 at Sam's Club. Yeah, so I'll talk to y'all later. Hey, everybody. Hey, hey, hey. I'm back from the Sam's Club. Let me just show you what I got really quick. Didn't buy too much. Y'all, I have to stop telling people where I'm at or going. Because every time I tell one of my family members where I'm at, somebody asks me to buy something. I told my sister I was going to Publix yesterday. She's like, oh, just pick me up one of those. Buy one, go one. It was screaming Sicilian pizza. Pepperoni, okay? And then I was like, my dad called to find out if I was still coming to do the invoice. And I was like, oh, yeah, I'm just going to go to Sam's Club first. And then he's like, oh, pick me up some grapes. I was like, you guys,
really?
This is not in my budget. Who's going to say no to my family? Not me. And so, on the board of queso chips. Pick some of those up. Not sure why, because it's going to be liquids for a while. But queso chips aren't going to expire. My bag of Caesar. I did not buy the salmon, though. So, I have Caesar salad. I don't know. I might just put up, like, one of the salmon packets in it and call it a day. Save my money. Earthbound spinach. This is for the smoothie. It's a big pack from Sam's Club. Y'all know this from Sam's Club. And the only other thing I bought was a big thing of fruits again. Really enjoyed these fruits, and they're individually packed bags of 1 pound in here. That is all I bought, you guys, at the Sam's Club. And then I bought 3-4. Yeah, and then I also bought water. I already put it in the living room, in the dining room. So I bought a piece of water. I spent $30-something. Technically $20-something if you don't count my dad's $7 grapes. So, yeah, that's all. Just wanted to update you. I'm going to cook some dinner now. Oh, and Grandma gave me dinner. I went to my parents' house, did the invoice. Grandma gave me dinner. Amen to her. Okay. Come on, Jesus. I might not even need it to cook. Yeah, I'm going to cook my chicken because it's in the fridge. I'm going to cook that, and I'm going to put just maybe like a cup of rice in to cook to make 2 cups because liquid diet. So I don't want to have too much food in the house. All right, y'all. I will let y'all see what's meal prepped. Talk to y'all later. All right, y'all. So the Food is done and prepped. We've got our broccoli and cheese, a cup of broccoli and cheese, a cup of white rice, and two chicken legs, stewed chicken legs, same here. And then this is the leftover chicken legs. I have too much food. I'm glad I didn't buy the salmon because I just realized, so I'll probably be eating the rest of the chicken legs with the salad in the evenings, because I just remembered that we're doing like a team building, thank you for your hard work, team thing on the 31st, which is I think Tuesday, and they're taking us out to eat. So I'm like, dang, they're taking us for lunch. So I'm like, I have too much food. And I already have food for tonight. I still have my, y'all know what that is. No, y'all don't. I still have my bully, y'all don't call it that, corned beef and rice that I can eat for dinner. Plus, my grandma gave me food, which I ate earlier. Bro, I am so blessed, over abundant with food right now. I have no complaints. If I wasn't doing that liquid thing, I'd be set. Now I feel like I have too much food. Anyway, I do want to probably go work on reconciling my credit card video. That way I can do my cash stuffing and unstuffing video. Yeah. All right, y'all. Talk to y'all later. If I don't talk to you later, this is probably the end. Here's the meal prep. That's what I'm fitting to do. You guys have a wonderful, blessed evening. Remember, all things are always working out for your good, for those who believe. And faith over fear this year. Not just this year, but what? Forever. Have you subscribed? Bye, Jazz Hands.